Well, one less lug there later. We snapped off another one on this car. He seemed to be notorious. That stud got broke off long ago. We just broke this one off. This one stripped out when we were taking it off just now. So we're down to two. I guess we're going to have to put at least one more new one in this or steal one off the back. We'll see what we come up with. But figured out the culprit of our problem here. Now, me having ran a different Sonata before this, I'm not surprised on what we discovered. Actually, this is exactly what happened to my 2001 Sonata when we derbied that. Same scenario, very, very similar suspension on these cars. So this curved spindle right here, this is, if you guys know your Hondas, same concept. But these Sonatas are notorious that when they get hit, the curved part will just take itself and it'll bend like this. And this arch right here runs itself back there towards the frame. So as you can see, that arch is now passing behind where this strut would be. So of course, right now our wheel is mostly straight. When we turn our wheel, it's going to pivot this arm and pivot like that, which makes this spindle smack right here into your strut, and therefore is what is causing us to have limited turning going left. The good news is I believe it is only because of this bent part here. The actual tie rod is good there, and these do come factory with this weird curve. You see this wonky curve? That is 100% original. Nothing's changed on that. So that's perfectly fine. That's how they're designed. I don't know. I don't like it, but it hasn't moved. So we're going to let that part go. I think all I need to do is get a different spindle, put a knuckle on the front of this guy, maybe definitely replace a couple of these guys while we're at it. Brakes are good on the car, no worries there. We'll do that, pop it back on with a new one, and see how the steering handles from that point on. If need be, we can adjust our tie rod since we now know it's okay. The threads are good, we can run the threads in and out, fix our steering a little bit to help us. There's a quick update. Let's go ahead and pull all of this apart and see what it looks like with that off and work on getting some new parts. All right, there we have it. The old spindle is off, and there is the used replacement, factory OEM replacement, by the way, not aftermarket, so it should be equal strength. But there they are, side by side, to show you guys the comparison. And I'll show you the best way to look at these is to get down here low. This one here on the left, that's the one that bent. This one on the right is still straight, no damage. So it looks like it bent about right there because this guy has more flat sitting on the concrete right there. This one is lifting up in the air. Also, if you zoom in enough, right there, oh boy, come on camera, focus. Right there, you can see the paint has popped off of this metal right there. That's because the metal has deformed right there on that edge, and that's where it's starting to bend. But honestly, that bend there isn't as bad as I had anticipated. I expected it to be much more curved when I took it off the car and compared it to the newer one. These do have a slight curve to them naturally. So that's good and bad, I suppose. Good news is this car took a very hard pavement shot in a derby, and it did not bend the spindle that much as expected. But the bad news is, in comparison, my 2001 Sonata, which was the generation Sonata before this one, it could actually bend way further, twice as much as this spindle, before it gave me any type of steering issues. With this Sonata, that curve that you see, that bent part, that much right there was enough to already cut your turn radius in half. So that tells me these newer, the next generation Sonatas, this is the 06, so that style here, that means they will inhibit your steering faster when they do start to bend. So that is something to address or try to figure out if you guys are going to run more of these cars. I do not know yet my game plan for that. But that is good to know, to see see how they bend, see where they bend. They basically bend in the exact same spot as the previous Sonatas spindles do. I just believe the only difference why you get steering problems so soon, I think, you can see here I pulled everything off. I think on these Sonatas, I think the spindle sits closer to this shock right here. I think the older Sonatas was further away. And also the older Sonatas, the spindle is directly centered right here in line with your shock. So when it gets hit and it bends, it smacks into that shock and it braces itself a little more. This next generation Sonata here on the 2006, the shock itself, I'm sorry, not the shock, the spindle offsets. It sits about right here. So when it starts to bend, it pushes back next to your shock. It doesn't have a natural kicker. This shock is a very natural kicker on the older Sonata. So that tells me I actually, the 2001 generation Sonata has a better suspension setup for Demolition Derby compared to this one here. Just a little tidbit I figured out here looking at these things. Other than that, that's the only damage on this car from that big shot. Everything else, we're going to button back up. So stay tuned. Let's go throw this right back on there.